So glad you're all here. Before we get started this evening, I would like to say a few words about the horrible events that happened in Paris this weekend. I wish I could say words in French about this. My mother was a middle school French teacher. She was my middle school French teacher. I was such a terrible student that about all I could do right now is list vegetables, colors, and maybe a few days of the week. So I think better if I use English to say, I think one of the most jarring things about what happened is Paris is a city that so many people associate with love, and what happened there was so the opposite of that. I love Paris. I've been there many times. I almost proposed to my wife in Paris. I should have. It would have made for a far less awkward, intense flight home. I got around to it. Sometimes you take time for these things. So I think that's what made me so sad about it was, you know, I associate so many nice things with Paris. But it also, thinking about that, you know, I realize there are other places where things like this happen all the time. Beirut also had a terrible bombing by ISIS last week as well, and I certainly was guilty of not paying the same level of attention to that atrocity. And, you know, when you think about the place where these terrible things are happening the most right now, it would be Syria, a place where the people who live there, who are trying to live normal lives, are so desperate to leave. And for those refugees whose life is so difficult right now, I think one of the many, and there are so many sad things about what happened in Paris, but certainly one of them is how much harder life is going to be for those refugees because of this. And so I would just spare a thought for all of the people who are affected by these tragic events. And hopefully things will be just a little bit better tomorrow, being Mardi, French for Tuesday. Nailed it. So thank you, everybody, for indulging me, and let's get to the news.